So help me welcome her right here and right now. The one and only Miss Autumn DeForest. I can't believe it. Every time I come back here, I feel like you grow a couple inches. This is cool. Well, let's tell me how to start. I mean, everybody here is probably wondering, okay, I've got a five-year-old. What do I do? You know, how does this work? I've got kids and grandkids. Tell them how you got into it.
Sure.
So I started painting in my late fives. I just skipped out the garage one day, and I saw my father staining some wood. And I asked him if I could mess around, and he said, sure. So I just picked up that paintbrush one day, and I started, and I wasn't interested in making a humongous masterpiece or anything. I was just having fun and expressing myself. And my father turned around, and he said it looked like a Rothko. And I had no idea what Rothko was back then, but he's one of my favorite artists now. So I started painting more and more, and I started doing huge canvases because I loved painting on a big size, on a huge canvas, so I could do big brush strokes and have a bigger imagination so I could export that onto a canvas. So I did more and more paintings, and most of my family and friends liked them, so I asked my father to enroll me in this little art in the park thing, and it was a lot of fun, you know, the ones with the white tents and the jewelry out on the tables, and everyone that was there were adults, and people would come up and they would say, oh, these paintings are fantastic. And they were talking to my father, and they thought it was take your daughter to work day. But when I greeted them and I spoke to them, it was so incredible because they asked me all of these great questions, like what are you inspired by? What materials do you use? What artists do you like? And at that point, I found a new passion. And at that point, I knew that art and painting was going to be what I wanted to do for the rest of my life, and it was going to be my passion. But I found a new thing, and that was talking about my artwork and giving it a story and giving it a meaning, not just to me, but to other people. So I, from that day forward, I always had a story for each one of my paintings. So I did more and more paintings and was inspired by more and more artists. And one day, every week on Friday, my family and I, we go to a bookstore, and I'm allowed to get one book. And we walked into the bookstore, and I saw this humongous book of Dolly. I mean, it was huge. And it had persistence of memory, you know, on the cover. And I fell in love with it. And I knew, you know, at that point, I didn't think really art could be that out there, yet that so detailed and beautiful, and the technical ability was incredible, yet the imagination was I mean, nothing that I'd ever seen. And I had been inspired by Jackson Pollock and some abstract artists, but never anyone like that. And I flipped, and I remember flipping through the book because the book was so big that it was from my knees to the ceiling of the car. And I loved it. It was so inspiring. So I did more and more paintings that were inspired by other artists. And you know, if painting was going to be my passion, I wanted to learn more about the artwork, about the art world and different eras of art. So I did more and more, and all of a sudden the Discovery Channel called. And I thought, wow, that's pretty cool. And at that point, I'd done a few local stations, but nothing like that. And they featured me on a show called Child Geniuses, and that was so much fun, a wonderful opportunity. And then the Today Show called, and I thought, wow, this is really taking off. And when I went to New York, the BBC shut down a part of Times Square to do an interview with me, and it was just wonderful. And since then, it's been Wendy Williams, ABC, NBC, all different kinds over 40 television appearances, and then I started working with Park West, and it's just been so wonderful, and it's such an honor to be able to travel the world and inspire and empower people with my artwork and show my artwork to everyone. It's just been a wonderful ride, and they've given me so many wonderful opportunities, and I just wanted to thank Michael Casacci right here. And I also want to thank Albert Scaglione, the founder of Park West. But most of all, I want to thank all of you for letting me tell you my story.
That was beautiful. Thank you. Can you believe that? How do you second that? I guess I'll try. Caught me off guard there, Avi. You said something to me that I thought was really important. I want to mention this to the clients too. And I kind of reiterate this sometimes, but you paint and you want stories with your artwork that have a connection with you, but also have a connection with the clients. And something that I think every artist should do that hasn't ever done, except for Autumn, is she actually provides her clients with background stories about the artwork that she ships to you. So that way, if you hear a story about a painting that is near and dear to your heart, not only do you not have to remember it because she's going to send it to you, but if you didn't hear the story about the painting, she's going to do her own write-up on the painting and send you the whole story behind it as well. Isn't that great? I think that's really nice. I've been telling all the artists, you gotta pick up on that. So I know that things are wildly busy for you. Autumn is amazing talent, there's no question that she's a child prodigy. She's starting to fill her place in the history books already. And coming out to do these shows, I know people tend to have a lot of questions about, you know, what your life is like as well, because the life of a professional artist can be a little crazy. Now you mix in the fact that she's a 14-year-old girl, and it goes totally different. Now, one thing that everybody always asks about Autumn is, you know, is she in school? And you're not in school, are you? Kind of.
Well, of course I am. I have an online curriculum, and where I go and they send me books, and I have a tutor, and I'm I'm allowed to kind of go at my own pace, so I can exceed in some subjects and have a little more help than others. And it's a lot of fun, and I really enjoy it. Some of them have other different courses that regular schools don't. Right now, I'm able to take psychology and more of an advanced art history class. And I'm able to expand a little more and do things that I'm a little bit more interested in, which I really, really like.
The reason I want to bring this up, too, is if you couldn't tell already, I was pretty smart. That's an understatement. I don't think she would fit in the typical school program, and I know that she has straight A's in her homeschooling program that she does, but it's a very advanced program, and she's got big plans. You know, you talk to Autumn about the future of her career in art, and obviously that's something that she dreams about being in forever, but also, where do you want to go to university?
I want to go to Yale University, and I want to get a master's degree in psychology and psychotherapy and forensics, and I also want to get a master's degree in business.
And be one of the most amazing professional artists on planet Earth as well. Not too bad, huh? I don't even want to think about what I was thinking about at 14, because I'm feeling pretty embarrassed right now. There's a special time of coming to Autumn Deforrest shows. Unlike some of the other artists that we work with, you know, Autumn doesn't have the ability to of course, create for 30 shows a year. You can't have her working, 12 hours a day, chain her up in the studio, even though we might like to. So whenever we do a show like this, it is always special. And I'm going to tell you, I was very nervous, because as of a week ago, I was looking through the collection for this event, and we had about 12 paintings for the show. And I was on pins and needles, wondering what was going to be happening with the Autumn Deforrest collection. Thinking, well, at least it'll be an easy sellout. That's not necessarily where we want it to be. And I could not be more thrilled with the outcome of what happened, and that is that Autumn has been spending the last few months knowing that the show is coming up, creating a collection for this show, and because they live in Las Vegas, they drove the paintings in, and we had frames shipped in, so now our collection is the biggest collection I've ever had of Autumn Deforrest works. And by that, it's about 40 original paintings. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to say thank you first and foremost to Autumn for creating this for us, because she's been working so hard to do it. Thank you, Autumn.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
But it's also some of the best work that you're ever going to see come from her. I want to get right into it. I want to show some paintings. I want tomorrow, I promise you this, tomorrow morning, we've got some pretty amazing things that I want to show you in terms of where her career is going. And I want to tell you a little bit more about it. But I think tonight I want to show you some paintings. So, you guys want to see some?
Yeah.
Yeah? I thought so. Well, where do you want to start, Josh? Right behind me? Let's go this way.
Okay.
Wayne, let's go. Good. The grand event for us, Josh.
Oh.
Tell us about it. And Josh, do you mind doing a little human diesel for us? Show people off to the other side.
So this painting is called Dripping Summer. And you can see right over that ridge right there is the ocean. You can smell the sea salt, you can hear the crashing waves, but you can't see it yet. And that this is the feeling that you get right before you can actually see the ocean. Each blade of grass represents each person who's been to this beach, and each beach ball represents a memory, a wonderful memory that someone has had of this beach that has been so historic and so such a beautiful place for so many people.
Awesome, ladies and gentlemen, the Dripping Summer. Hey, Josh. Now, you know, instantly, I look at this painting. Well, you show that they have people that are asking.
Yeah, sorry.
No worries. You guys want to see it too, don't you?
Yeah.
I want to check out the texture of this work too. Now, I'm noticing the texture built up in the blue and in the sand. That does not look like a typical oil or acrylic painting to me, on it. I don't know what that is.
Well, it is acrylic. However, as you can see, some of the, you may be able to see it better if you come up closer. This is all three-dimensional relief right here, and that's all built up with artistic gel. And I really, really love to use that because it gives the painting an entirely different dimension, you know. I love having not only you being able to see the ridge, but also being able to feel it and really get that feeling. And having the painting flat can be great. You know, you can use your technical ability to really get the ridge feeling, but when you're really able to feel it and almost have that taken care of itself, where it's a real ridge, I really enjoy having that. As you can see, a lot of this really looks like sand real blades of grass. So you really get a beach.
Well, whenever you have texture in painting, you instantly create more surface area for the light to reflect around it. And when that happens, it brings in a tactile experience for the viewer because it instantly makes you realize that it's texture. And as a viewer, the first thing you want to do then is touch it. You want to go up and touch it. It's an instant reaction that your brain has when you see texture in a painting and light reflecting over the surface. So obviously, I know not everybody's going to go up and touch it. It probably wouldn't hurt the painting, but realize that that's a great thing. It draws people in. It wants them engaged and up close. And that's just a great painting. I look at that. On this side, I see a jovial approach. Something that's innocent and sweet and beautiful and almost childlike, but yet has an incredible artistic feel to it, and is technically a very strong painting as well, with that childlike kind of fun influence to it. Getting into one of the more serious ones, which one do we have over here that's the... Let's go for this one next. I want to go into a slightly more serious subject matter in Autumn and kind of draw your attention to the opposite side of the room. Maybe you could tell us a little bit about this one.
Sure.
I was blown away by this and the more kind of sophisticated approach and really a more adult style to it. Tell us about this.
Sure. So this painting is called Goodnight Moon. And right here, you can see this this house. This used to be a happy home. A grandmother used to live here, and her daughter and grandchildren would come over all the time. And she'd sit in this window right here and watch her grandchildren play. But one day, the grandmother died.